In Creo Parametric, the mechanism weld connection is used when you want to fix one component rigidly to an existing component in the assembly, but maintain the subassembly's internal degrees of freedom. Let's see what I mean by that. So here I have an assembly. It's got this panel in it. I've also got a linear actuator courtesy of Thompson Linear. Thank you again for your CAD models. I'm going to open this up in its own separate window. With this linear actuator, I can use the drag function and click on this component. You can see that it is capable of sliding. It's got one translational degree of freedom. Let's go back to the assembly. Right now, the linear actuator does not have any constraints in it. So let me edit definition. I'm going to turn on my axis and plane display for a moment. First, I want to have a pin connection over on the left-hand side, and I've got some assembly datums I can use for that. Let's go to the placement tab. I'm gonna use the user-defined drop-down list and change this to a pin connection. Let's select this axis over here and zoom in, and let me turn off the display of my 3D dragger. Just make it easier to grab that axis. For eliminating translation, I will use the assembly front plane from the assembly and this other plane over here. So that is good for my pin connection, and this is capable of rotating. I've got one rotational degree of freedom. Let me turn off my datum display over here, and let's say that I want the other end to be rigidly fixed to this component over here, but I still want it to be able to translate in the 1 degree of freedom. To do that, you can add in a second set, and that can be of the type weld. But the thing with the weld is that it uses a coordinate system as references. So you may need to create your coordinate systems in order to do that. Let me delete this second connection over here and hit the check mark. Now let's open up the individual components in their own separate windows in order to create the necessary coordinate systems. Let me turn on my axis display for reference. And so the first thing for creating the coordinate system is I need to define the origin. Let me select the intersection of these two axes over here. Then I'll go to the orientation tab. And let's see, right now it is using this axis to define X. And let's use that for Z for translation. Let me flip it. I want Z pointing in the other direction. And then right now it's using the A1 axis to determine the Y direction. Maybe I want that to be X. It really doesn't matter the orientation. I just have to make sure that this coordinate system matches up with the coordinate system in the other part for the weld connection. So that's good over there. Let's click the OK button. I'm gonna turn on my coordinate system visibility for a second. So you can see that Z is pointing along the direction of translation and Y is pointing up. Let's go back over to my assembly. And now I'm gonna open up this component over here in its own separate window. Let's create a coordinate system once more. And again, I will select these two different axes over here as the reference. Let's go to the orientation tab. Right now, it is using the A4 axis for X. That's good. This A1 axis, I think I need this to be the Z direction. And let's flip it. And again, I'm just making sure that's matching up the orientation of the other coordinate system. That is good. Let's click the OK button. And let's go back to our assembly. Let me edit definition of the linear actuator. Let's go to the placement tab. And once again, I'm going to create an additional connection set. And that's one thing that you'll see with mechanism components. Oftentimes, they might have more than one connection. And again, this is going to be of the type weld. Now for my references, let's select this coordinate system over here and that coordinate system over there. They are connected. It says my connection definition is complete. Now I will hit the check mark. Let's turn off the display of the different datums. And I have this component rigidly assembled using constraints in here. Let's use the edit button. Right now, we'll change the offset distance for how it's assembled. Let's change this to 75. and then I will use the regenerate icon. And you'll notice that this component moved and the slider connection in the linear actuator updated automatically. Let's go back to this one and again use the modify. Let's try value of 100 and then regenerate. And then again, the slider updates in here. So here we have, with that weld connection, we have these two components rigidly fixed to one another, but you're still able to translate the slider according to its degrees of freedom. I hope you enjoyed this video. For more information, please visit www.creowindchill.com. If you learned something from this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you like this video, please click the subscribe button to be informed when new videos are uploaded. Thank you very much.